Chapter number 4, Carbon and its compounds. In the previous chapter, we have studied about many compounds of great importance to us. In this chapter, we shall study about some more interesting compounds and their properties. Also, we shall study about carbon and element, which is very important for us in both its elemental form and in the combined form, activity 1. Make a list of 10 things you have consumed or used since the morning. Compile this list with the list made by your friends and then sort the atoms into the adjacent table. If there are things which are made up of more than one material, put them into both the relevant columns. Look at the things that come into the last column of the above table filled by you. Your teacher can tell you that most of them are made up of compounds of carbon. Can you think of a method to check this? What would be the product if a compound having carbon is burnt? Do you know of any method to confirm this? Be it food, medicines, clothes, books, or many other things that you listed, all of these are based on this versatile element carbon. In addition, all living structures are based on carbon. The amount of carbon present in the atmosphere and in the earth's crust is quite large. The earth's crust contains only 0.02% carbon in the form of minerals such as carbonates, hydrogen carbonates, petroleum and coal. And the atmosphere has 0.03% of carbon dioxide in spite of which a small amount of carbon present in nature. The importance of carbon seems to be immense in this chapter. We will know about the properties of carbon which make carbon so important to us. Bonding in carbon, the covalent bond in the last chapter, we have studied about the properties of ionic compounds. We saw that ionic compounds have a high boiling and melting points and conduct electricity in the molten state or in solution. We also noticed how the nature of bonding in ionic compounds tells these properties. Let us now study about the properties of some carbon compounds, boiling and melting points of some carbon compounds as given in table 1. Most of the carbon compounds are poor conductors of electricity, as we have studied in chapter 2 from the data given in table 1. On the melting point and boiling points of the carbon compounds, we find that these compounds have low melting and boiling points as compared to ionic compounds. Chapter 3, we can think that the forces of attraction are not very strong between the molecules since these compounds are very bad conductors of electricity. We can find out that the bonding in these compounds does not produce any ions. In our previous class, we have studied about the combined capacity of different elements and how it depends on the number of valence electrons. Let us now see the electronic configuration of a carbon. The atomic number of a carbon is 6. What would be the arrangement of electrons in various shells of a carbon? How many valence electrons will carbon contain? We know that the reactivity of elements is described as their tendency to attain a completely filled outer shell, that is, attain noble gas configuration. Elements producing ionic compounds get this by either losing or gaining electrons from the outermost shell. In the case of carbon, it has 4 valence electrons in its outermost shell and needs to lose or gain 4 electrons to attain noble gas configuration. If it were to gain or lose electrons, it could gain 4 electrons forming C4- ion. But it would be so much difficult for the nucleus having 6 protons to hold on to 10 electrons. That is 4 extra electrons it could lose for electrons producing C4+ cation. But it would need a large amount of energy for the removal of 4 electrons leaving behind a carbon cation having 6 protons in its nucleus holding on to just 2 electrons. Carbon can overcome this problem by sharing electrons with other atoms of carbon or with atoms of other elements, not just carbon, but many other elements produce molecules by sharing electrons in the same way. The shared electrons belong to the outermost shells of both the atoms and tends to attaining the noble gas configuration to both atoms. Before talking about compounds of carbon, let us look at some simple molecules produced by the sharing of valence electrons. The simplest molecule produced in this way is that of hydrogen, as you have studied earlier. The atomic number of hydrogen is 1, hence hydrogen contains 1 electron in its K shell, and it needs 1 more electron to produce the K shell, so 2 hydrogen atoms share their electrons to produce a molecule of hydrogen, H2. This leads to each hydrogen atom to attain the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas, helium, which has 2 electrons in its outermost K shell. We can depict this using crosses or dots to show the valence electrons. The shared pair of electrons is said to form a single covalent bond between the 2 hydrogen atoms. A single covalent bond is also represented by a single line drawn between the 2 atoms as shown in figure. The atomic number of chlorine is 17. What would be the electronic configuration and valency of chlorine? Chlorine produces a diatomic molecule, Cl2. Can you draw the electron dot structure for Cl2 molecule? Observe that only the valence shell electrons need to be depicted. In the case of hydrogen, in the case of oxygen, we see the double bonding between 2 oxygen atoms. This is because an atom of oxygen contains 6 electrons in its outermost AL shell. The atomic number of oxygen is 8, and it needs 2 more electrons to fulfill its octet. So each atom of oxygen shares 2 electrons with other atom of oxygen to form the following structure. The 2 electrons given by each oxygen atom form 2 shared pairs of electrons. This is said to form a double bond between the 2 atoms. Now can you depict a molecule of water representing the nature of bonding between the oxygen atom and 2 hydrogen atoms? Does the molecule have double bonds or single bonds? What would occur in the case of a dimeric molecule of nitrogen? The atomic number of nitrogen is 7. What would be its electronic configuration and its valency? In order to get an octet, each nitrogen atom in 3 shared pairs of electrons. This is said to form a triple bond between the 2 atoms. The electron dot structure of N2 and its triple bond can be represented as in figure D. A molecule of ammonia has the chemical formula NH3. Can you draw the electron dot structure for thin molecule describing how all 4 atoms get a noble gas configuration? Will the molecule contain single bonds, double bonds or triple bonds? Let us look at methane, which is a compound of a carbon. Methane is used widely as a fuel and is a main compound of a biogas and compressed natural gas CNG, and is also one of the simplest of the different compounds of carbon. The formula of methane is CH4. Hydrogen, as you know, has a 1 valence electron. Electron carbon is a tetravalent because it contains 4 valency electrons. In order to get noble gas configuration, carbon shares these electrons with 4 atoms of hydrogen as represented in figure. These bonds formed by the sharing of an electron pair between 2 atoms and called as covalent bonds. Covalently bonded molecules have strong bonds within the molecule, but intermolecular forces between them are weak. This leads to the low melting and boiling points of these compounds. Since there is a sharing of the electrons between atoms and no charged particles are formed, such covalent compounds are usually bad conductors of electricity. Versatile nature of carbon. We have studied the formation of covalent bonds by the sharing of electrons in different elements and compounds. We have also studied the structure of a simple carbon compound, methane, in the starting of the chapter. We saw how many things we each have carbon. In fact, we ourselves are made up of carbon compounds. The number of carbon-containing compounds which chemical formula are known to chemist was estimated to be in millions. This outnumber by a large margin the compounds produced by all the other elements put together. Why is it that this property is observed in carbon and no other element? The nature of the covalent bond makes the carbon able to produce a large number of compounds. So two factors are observed in the case of carbon. Carbon has the specific ability to form bonds with other atoms of carbon, forming a large number of molecules. This property is known as continuation. These compounds may contain long chains of carbon, carbon branched chains of carbon, or even carbon. Atoms may be bonded by single, double, or triple bonds. Compounds of carbon which are bonded by only single bonds between the carbon atoms are known as saturated compounds. Compounds of carbon containing double or triple bonds between carbon atoms are known as unsaturated compounds. No other element has the property of continuation to the extent observed in carbon compounds. Silicon produces compounds with hydrogen which contain chains of up to 7 or 8 atoms. But these compounds are highly reactive. The carbon-carbon bond is very strong bond and hence stable. This provides us the large number of compounds having many carbon atoms bonded with each other. Since carbon contains a valency of 4, It is able to make a bond with four other atoms of carbon or some other element. Compounds of carbon are produced with oxygen, hydrogen, sulfur, nitrogen, chlorine, and many other elements, producing compounds with unique properties which depend on the elements other than carbon present in the molecule. Again, the bond formed by carbon with most other elements is very strong, which enables these compounds. Exceptionally stable. One reason for the making strong bonds by carbon is it's small, the shared pair of electrons strongly. The bonds formed by elements containing bigger atoms are much weaker. Saturated and unsaturated carbon compounds. We have already studied about the structure of methane. Another compound produced between carbon and hydrogen is ethane, having a chemical formula of Ca2H6. To get the structure of simple carbon compounds, the first step is to link the carbon atoms together with a single bond, and then the atoms of hydrogen are used to fulfill the remaining valences of carbon. For instance, ethane is first ratanase. Three valences of each carbon atom remains unfulfilled, so H is bonded to three hydrogen atoms, giving the following structure. The electron dot structure of ethane is represented in figure C. Can you draw the structure of propane, which has the molecular formula C3H8, in the same way? You will observe that the valences of all the atoms are fulfilled by single bonds between them. Such carbon compounds are known as saturated compounds. These compounds are generally non-reactive. Hence, another compounds of carbon and hydrogen has the chemical formula C2H4 and is named ethane. Now, can this molecule be duplicated? We follow the same steps as followed in the above example. Step number 1, carbon-carbon atoms linked together with a single bond. Step number 2, we observe that one valency per carbon atoms remains unsatisfied. This carbon be satisfied only if there may be a double bond between the two carbons, giving the structure as follows. The electron dot structure draw for ethane is shown in figure given below. As another compound of hydrogen and carbon as the chemical formula C2H2 and is called ethane. Can you draw the electron dot structure for ethane? How many bonds are required between the two carbon atoms to satisfy their valences? Such compounds of a carbon containing double or triple bonds between the two carbon atoms are called as unsaturated carbon compounds, and they are highly reactive in comparison to the saturated carbon compounds. Chains, branches and rings. In the earlier section, we mentioned the carbon compounds methane, ethane and propane containing respectively 1, 2 and 3 carbon atoms. Such chains of carbon atoms can contain many more of carbon atoms. The names and structures of 6 of these are given in table 2. But let us look at butane again. If we make the carbon chain with 4 carbon atoms, we find that 2 different possible skeletons are. Satisfication of the remaining valences with hydrogen gives us flowing structures. We find that both these structures have the same formula, C4H10. Such compounds with similar molecular formula but have different structures are known as structural isomers. In addition to straight and branched carbon chains, some compounds contain carbon atoms arranged in the form of a ring. For example, cyclohexane as the H, the chemical formula C6H12M, and the structure given below. Can you draw the electron dot structure for cyclohexane? The compounds having straight chain, branched chain, and cyclic carbon all may be unsaturated or saturated. For instance, benzene C6H6 has the structure given in figure. All these carbon compounds which have only carbon and hydrogen are known as hydrocarbons. Among these, the saturated hydrocarbons are known as alkanes. The unsaturated hydrocarbons which have one or more double bonds are known as alkenes. Those compounds containing one or more triple bonds are known as alkynes. Will you be my friend? Carbon is a very friendly element. So far we have been finding compounds containing hydrogen and carbon only, but carbon also forms bonds with other elements like halogens, oxygen, sulfur and nitrogen. In a hydrocarbon chain, one or more hydrogens can be displaced by these elements so that the valency of a carbon remains satisfied. In these compounds, the element replacing hydrogen is represented as a heteroatom. These heteroatoms show specific properties to the compound regardless of the nature and length of the carbon chain, and therefore these are known as functional groups. Some useful functional groups are given in the table 3. Prevalency or valences of the group has been represented by the single line. The functional group is bonded with the carbon chain by these valency by replacing hydrogen atom or atoms. Homologous series you have studied that carbon atoms can be bonded together to make chains of different lengths. The chains can be branched also. In addition, hydrogen atom or other atoms on these carbon chains can be replaced by any of the functional groups that we observed above. The presence of a functional group such as alcohol decides the properties of the carbon compound regardless of the length of the carbon chain. For instance, the chemical properties of C3H7OH, C3OH, C2H5OH and C4H9OH are all identical. Hence, such a series of compounds in which the same functional group substitutes for hydrogen on a carbon chain is known as a homologous series. Let us see a simple homologous series that we studied earlier in table 2. If we see the formula of successive compounds, say, what is the difference between the next pair, butane and propane? Can you find out the difference in molecular masses between each pair? The atomic mass of carbon is 12 U and the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1 U. Take the homologous series similarly. For alkenes, the first member of the series is ethane, about which we have already studied in section 4.2.1. What is the chemical formula for ethane? The next members have the chemical formula C3H6, C5H10 and C4H8. Do these also differ by CH2 unit? Do you see any correlation between the number of hydrogen and carbon atoms in these compounds? The common formula for alkanes can be represented as CnH2n. Can you generate similarly the general formula for alkynes and alkanes? As the molecular mass increases in any homologous series, a gradation in physical properties is observed as the boiling points and melting points increase with the increasing molecular mass. Some other physical properties like solubility in a particular solvent also represent a similar gradation, but the chemical properties which are represented slowly by the functional group remain same in a homologous series. Activity 2, calculate the difference in the molecular masses and formula 4. Is there any similarity in the three arranged alcohols on the basis of their increasing carbon atoms to achieve a family? Can we say this family a homologous series? From a homologous series up to compounds having four carbon atoms for other functional groups. So in table 3, nomenclature of carbon compounds. The names of compounds in a homologous series are determined on the basis of the name of the basic carbon chain modified by a prefix or suffix representing the nature of the functional group. For instance, the names of the alcohols given in activity 2 are methyl, ethanol, butanol and propanol. Naming a carbon compound can be done by the following method. Find out the number of carbon atoms present in the compound. A compound containing 3 carbon atoms would have the name propane. In case a functional group is present, it is represented in the same of the compound with either a prefix or a suffix as shown in table 4. If the name of the function group is to be taken as a suffix and the suffix of the function group begins with a vowel A-E-I-O-U, then the name of the carbon chain is modified by removing the final E and substituting the right suffix. So for instance, a 3 carbon chain having a ketone group would be named in the manner given below, propene. If the carbon chain is unsaturated, then the final N in the name of the carbon chain is replaced by ANE or YNE as shown in table 4. For instance, a 3 carbon chain having a double bond would be called propane, and if it has a triple bond, it would be known as a propane. Chemical properties of carbon compounds. In this section, we shall study about some of the chemical properties of carbon compounds. Since most of the fuels which we use are either carbon or its compounds, first of all, we shall study combustions in all allotropic forms, carbon ones in oxygen to produce carbon dioxide along with heat and light. On burning, most of carbon compounds also produce a large amount of heat and light. These are the oxidation reactions that you studied about the previous chapter. Balance the latter two reactions like you studied in the first chapter. Unsaturated hydrocarbons will generally give a yellow flame with loads of black smoke, while saturated carbon compounds will give a green flame. This leads to the sooty deposit on the metal plate in activity 2, the sooty deposit on the metal plate in activity. Although limit the supply of air results in incomplete combustion of even saturated hydrocarbons, giving a sooty flame. The gas corrosion stove used at the same at home has inlets for the passage of air so that a sufficiently oxygen rich mixture is burnt to produce a clean blue flame. If you see the bottoms of vessels getting blanketed, if it shows that the air holes get blocked and fuel is get washed wasted. Fuels like petroleum and coal have some amount of sulfur and nitrogen in them. Their burning results in the production of oxides of sulfur and nitrogen, which are the main pollutants in the environment. Oxidation. You have studied about oxidation reactions in the chapter 1. Carbon compounds can be oxidized easily on combustion. In addition to this complete oxidation, we have reactions in which alcohols are changed into carboxylic acids. We have studied that some substances are capable of adding oxygen to other substances. So these substances are called as oxidizing agents. Acidified potassium dicarbonate or alkaline potassium permanganate are oxidizing alcohols to acids. That is adding oxygen to the starting material. Thus, they are called as oxidizing agents. Addition reaction and unsaturated hydrocarbons add hydrogen in the presence of catalysts like nickel or palladium to produce saturated hydrocarbons. Catalysts are the substances which cause a reaction to produce or occur at a different rate without itself being affected. This reaction is generally used in the hydrogen of vegetable oils. Using a nickel catalyst, vegetable oils usually contain long unsaturated carbon chains, while animal fats contain saturated carbon chains. You must have seen advertisements showing that some vegetable oils are healthy. Animal fats like butter and ghee contain saturated fatty acids, which are known to be bad for health. Oils having unsaturated fatty acids should be used for cooking. Substitutions reaction. Saturated hydrocarbons are fairly unreactive and are inert in the presence of most reagents. However, when chlorine is added to hydrocarbons in the presence of sunlight, it's in a very fast reaction. It can replace the hydrogen atoms one by one. It is known as a substitution reaction because one kind of atom or group of atoms replaces the other. Another, a number of products are generally produced by the higher homologies of alkynes. A potent carbon compounds, ethanol and ethanoic acid. Many carbon compounds have no value to us, but here we shall study about the properties of two commercially useful compounds, ethanol and ethanoic acid. Properties of ethanol. Ethanol occurs in a liquid state at room temperature. Refer to table 1 for the boiling and melting points of ethanol. Ethanol is generally called alcohol and is very effective ingredient of all alcoholic drinks. In addition, because it is a good solvent, it is also used in medicines like cough syrup, tincture, iodine, and many tonics. Ethanol is also soluble in water in all proportions. Use of little quantities of dilute ethanol causes drunkenness. It is a socially widespread practice. Even intake of a smell. Quantity of pure ethanol called absolute alcohol can be lethal. Also, long-term abuse of alcohol results in many health problems. Alcohols combined with sodium results in the production of hydrogen. With ethanol, the other product is formed sodium ethoxide. Can you recall which other substances evolve hydrogen on coming with metals reaction to produce unsaturated hydrocarbon? Heating ethanol with excess concentrated sulfuric acid at 443 K leads to the dehydration of ethanol to produce ethane. The concentrated sulfuric acid can be taken as a dehydrating agent, which results in the removal of water from ethanol. How do alcohols affect living beings? When large quantities of ethanol are used, it results in the slow metabolic process and to the depression in the central nervous system. This leads to the lack of coordination, metal confusion. Properties of properties of ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid is generally called acetic acid and belongs to a group of acids known as carboxylic acids. Dilute acetic acid is called vinegar and has a wide spread use as a preservative in pickles. The melting point of pure ethanoic acid is 290 K, and hence it often freezes in cold climates during water. That is why it is called glacial acidic fluid, acetic acid. The group of organic compounds known as carboxylic acids are characterized acid by their acidic nature. However, carboxylic acids are weak acids unlike mineral acids like HCl, which are completely ionized. Reactions of ethanoic acid: esterification reaction. Esters are commonly produced by the reaction of an acid and an alcohol. Ethanoic acid combines with ethanol in the presence of an acid catalyst to produce an ester. Generally esters are the substances of sweet swelling. These are used in the formation of perfumes and as flavoring agents. Esters react in the presence of an acid or a base to produce back the carboxylic acid and alcohol. This reaction is called as osmotification because it is used in the formation of soap. Soaps are sodium or potassium salts or long chain carboxylic acid. Reaction with a base such as material acids. Ethanoic acid reacts with a base like sodium hydroxide to produce a salt, sodium ethanoate, or generally called sodium acetate and water. How does ethanoic acid react with carbonates and hydrogen carbonates? Let us perform an activity. Reaction with carbonates and hydrogen carbonates. Ethanoic acid reacts with carbonates and hydrogen carbonates to produce a salt, water and hydrogen dioxide. The salt produced is generally called sodium acetate. This activity shows the effect of soap is in cleaning. Most dirt have only oily nature, and as you know, oil is not soluble in water. The molecules of soap are potassium or sodium salts of a long chain of carboxylic acids. The ionic end of soap interacts with water, while the carbon ionic ends of soap interacts with water, while the carbon chain interacts with oil. The soap molecules thus produce structures called micelles, where one end of the molecules faces the oil droplet, while the acid end is towards outside. This produces an emulsion in water. The soap micelle thus helps in pulling out the dirt in water, and we can cleanly wash our clothes. Can you draw the structure of the micelle that would be produced if you mix the soap in a hydrocarbon? Have you even noticed while bathing that foam is produced with difficulty and an insoluble substance, a scan, remains behind after washing with water? This is because of the reaction of soap with the magnesium and calcium salts, which cause the hardness of water. Hence, you have to use a large amount of soap. This problem is overcome by using another class of compounds, as generally sodium salts of sulfuric acids or ammonium salts with chlorides or bromides ions. It is both long hydrocarbon chain. The charged ends of these compounds do not produce insoluble precipitates with the magnesium and calcium ions in hard water. Hence, they remain effective in hard water. Detergents are generally used to make shampoos and products for cleaning clothes.